Vi fortsätter mot Chile till Katarina Janssons Santiago. Om man vill skaffa sig ett kreativt yrke här ska man inte vänta sig stöd från familj och vänner. Det gäller att brinna så mycket för sin dröm att man är villig att kämpa ensam. Man måste övertyga alla runt omkring en om att man trots allt valt rätt i livet. Tamara är en av dem som fyller sitt liv med kreativa projekt. Hon söker ständigt efter nya idéer. Och de mest unika idéerna hittar man ofta på de mest oväntade platser.
Här i Santiago är det många unga vuxna som driver egna företag. Man vill skapa och bygga sin egen framtid. Och ofta är det också lönsammare att vara egenföretagare. För att komma igång krävs bra och unika idéer. Det är många som försöker att bygga sin framtid och en del lyckas. Idag ska vi träffa en ung kvinna som alltid brunnit för att göra film. Vi befinner oss i Providencia i östra delen av Santiago. Och här någonstans bor Tamara som vi ska träffa idag.
Hi, how are you?
For me, it's important when I'm making a movie or a short film or anything that it makes people feel happy about themselves and about life and give you like a positive angle of life. The short film that I'm working on right now, it's about this postcard. This postcard, I found it on a second handbook. And at the time that I found it, I didn't know the language was Icelandic. And this letter came from Iceland and is from 1989. This short film is around the thoughts that people have while they are reading this letter without knowing the language. So it's about their imaginations and their thoughts and the thing that this simple postcard generates in them. So today we are going to meet the Icelandic girl.
And she's the author of the postcard?
Yes, the author.
Does she live in Santiago?
I still don't know if she's in Santiago, but I'm not sure if she lives in Santiago.
I think that's very nice. I mean, I am meeting new people in a very unconventional way. I don't know, kind of magical.
Hi, nice to meet you. I'm Katarina.
I think I have something that belongs to you, and it's this postcard.
My mom wrote it when my dad was in Denmark.
I got this letter, I remember I was living in Odense at the time.
I was alone with my child, and she was just 6 years old, and we miss him a lot in the home.
Because I remember this time, really. It was difficult. I mean, it was difficult for us at this time to be separated that long. Probably this card I used like a bookmark. Looking at this postcard, Bridges, I think it's started to look like us, really, now. Finally, we'll probably get both like this and still be kissing, what? Yeah. We have a lot of pictures and a lot of videos. We're keeping together over 30 years, so we've been trying to keep hold of the family history, especially as we are moving a lot. We've been in Denmark and now we've been over 20 years in Chile.
Now that I met them, they have been together all these years. I mean, they have been together their whole lives and they have a grown-up daughter and they have grandchildren. So I think that's one beautiful thing about love, like a lasting love. Put the energy to my computer, please. Today I'm very excited because I am showing the short film.
It's blinking and it's on. Här bakom mig så är Tamaras kompisar som har kommit för att titta på hennes kortfilm som har blivit klar idag.
Thank you all for coming. This is a very special short film for me. It was a long trip to this postcard to get to me and then to get again to their owners.
Some time ago, I bought a second handbook. I was very surprised when inside it I found an old postcard. And not only that, this postcard was dated in August 1989.
She has some kind of deadline and she will be there around by 10 September.
I'm always on the hunt for new experiences, for magical stories, and I think they never end. I mean, there's always a new one.
Good job. That was a good short film.
Thank you.